So over the past few weeks, I've been playing Granny on my spare time. By the way, maybe I'll do a stream, but that's if I get a good app for streaming. And I do! Check out my Twitch, it's KitCaveG, and be sure if you're a fan of the channel, that you follow to see my latest mobile game streams. Now back to the video. So I've been playing Granny for the past few weeks, before and after streams and whatnot. I noticed something. There is a sequel to the game called Granny Chapter 2, and it is filled to the brim with secrets. Sandrina's baby, her husband, and many others that I'm sure are to be discovered. But what intrigues me is that the game takes place at Grandpa's house. It's a tiny detail that many people gloss over in their first time playing. But then I saw the theory on YouTube and I got an idea. Is Granny Chapter 2 a prequel or a sequel to the original game for Android and iOS? This is like a FNAF 1 and 2 situation where the games give subtle hints that it's a prequel, but at the same time, I never found any subtle hints. Until now, because I found some information that will blow your mind for sure. But we first need to look at a theory that actually takes the prequel theory a step further by saying, is Granny Chapter 2 not only a prequel, but is it also about the first Granny victim? Now, there is significant amounts of evidence that this is not the case. Let me introduce the letter in the first Granny game. The letter never mentions Grandpa at all, first red flag, but also mentions that Granny sometimes hides things inside fruits, most notably the melon, which usually contains the padlock key, and most of the times I've actually played the game. But, yet, there are no fruits of any kind in Chapter 2, so while this theory is a good idea on paper, it simply isn't a reliable one as I've just proven. Now on to the next theory. Is Granny Chapter 2 a prequel? Yes! Here's why. I now present to you the dramatically convenient evidence to prove this. We can see in the opening prologue to the PC version of Granny Chapter 2 that we do wake up in the room like normal, but Granny knocks the player out again. Something's not right. She drives her car with the player, presumably tied up in the back seat, as we cannot move at all in this cutscene. She then pulls up at Grandpa's house, and then the game begins. I find it odd that the game doesn't start with her already at the house in the cutscene, but rather taking us there by force. We know this isn't normal, especially in a game about this psycho. It's almost as if she's not succeeding at what she does best. As if she's scared of the player's will to live. She's been shot with a tranquilizer, she's been frozen, she's also, surprisingly enough, been shot with a gun. Regardless of the ammunition being something completely different from a regular bullet used today, she should still die from a gunshot wound at that range that the average player will kill her from a distance. Shooting from a very, very close range should harm both Granny and the player, which also isn't the case. So Granny does seem to be immortal, but she isn't a zombie like some players of the game suggest, because zombies still die from gunshots. I know, theory for another time, but just wanted to get this off my chest. Our next big piece of evidence that the game is a prequel is Grandpa himself. I know this sounds very stupid, but hear me out. The room you get the freeze trap in has the skeleton of a person inside. Now you could easily say that this is the first victim, unless you think about it this way. What if Grandpa is the first victim? The skeleton seems to be the same height as Grandpa from looking at it, other than that we have the meat in the closet and the slab of meat used to feed the spider, which is where things take a dark turn. Let me set the scene. Granny's victims always look for her house because of injury. Injury would mean that there is a need for shelter, and Granny's house just so happens to be there. The injuries might be Granny's fault too, traps and gizmos capable of stopping people near the house in any way. She would proceed to knock the person out only for them to wake up in the room upstairs, in which she knocks them out again. Why she doesn't take them to the car after being knocked out the first time? Easy answer. If they're knocked out twice, they're twice as weak, making it easier for them to get caught, and then they are transported to Grandpa's house so that they can double-team the player, making it easier to kill them. Pretty successful method, until now. Now there are the dark parts of this theory. We know that in Chapter 2, you can kill the child of Sandrina with the shotgun. After this happens, of course, Granny gets upset, most likely leaving Grandpa's house forever. Grandpa couldn't stop the player from killing their great-grandchild, She becomes insane and knocks out the love of her life, takes him to her house, and gives him the 5 days method as always, that Grandpa and Granny had used for a long time on helpless victims. He dies. She keeps his organs as a lifelong supply of food, and uses it to feed her pet as well. Throws his old bones in the basement under her secret room in the house with the bird, locks the door, and sets up a puzzle. This would be Granny's first victim in her own house. Remember that. The first victim talks about things that don't appear in the sequel. So this is her first victim. It is confirmed. Granny Chapter 2 is the beginning of a mad woman who becomes even more insane following the death of her great-grandchild and kills her husband for his incompetence, further supported by the fact that the game says Grandpa doesn't hear very well like Granny. So we even have canon proof. I wasn't expecting to prove all of this in one video, but I did. Pretty interesting when you look at all the evidence that Grandpa might have been the first victim. And I believe it to be so. You can make of it what you will. But anyways, I'll be doing a Granny stream this Sunday, so if you would like to join, be sure to follow my Twitch account, KitKaveG, there's no spaces, and not miss a thing. It'll be at 3 o'clock p.m., but anyways, see you later, everyone.